Graham. Say what's up, America. I think you should know me, right? Other half a replica. Hello guys, this is Raj Shivare from Learn Anything, and in this video I'm gonna tell you how you can use GTTS, that is Google Text to Speech module of Python. Well, the things you need to know before using Google Text to Speech. First thing, it needs a constant internet connection. You can see that I have connected to internet here. Okay, so the second thing is that it gives you only 50 calls per day if you are using it for free. And you have to buy it, you have to give some money, you have to spend money to get more calls, like 10,000 calls per day. And in this video, I'm gonna show you how you can use it. Well, actually, mainly we use it for the speech recognition, okay, guys? Because it is fast and it is really, really accurate. Just like the Sphinx Base, which is not unlike the Sphinx Base, Pocket Sphinx, sorry. Unlike the Pocket Sphinx, it is really good, and the accuracy is almost 100%. It is around 99.8% accurate, but the thing is that it gives you only 50 calls a day. That means it is also having some, you know, problems and drawbacks, like this, like the Pocket Sphinx. Since the Pocket Sphinx is free and open source and offline, but that does not give you accuracy and speed, but it gives you accuracy and speed, but it is not free and not open source also. So we should start now. So first of all, I'm gonna open my IDLE. So this is the IDLE. Well, I'm using Python 2.7.13, and I recommend you also to use it, because it supports almost every module and it does not give you any glitch almost 99.9% times. So GTTS is a module that you can directly install from the command center, from the command prompt, sorry. So go to the scripts folder of your Python folder and tap this command, pip install GTTS. And once you press enter, it will start downloading, and after downloading, it will install it directly on your computer. That means you don't have to wait, you don't have to first download it and then install it manually. It will do everything automatically and at the one go only. So I have actually already installed it, so it will definitely show me the message that all requirements are satisfied, you know, this kind of message. But if you install it from this source, you will not get any glitch. So you can see that all requirements already satisfied. GTTS in C, Python 27 LIB set packages. Requirements are already satisfied. Requests in C, Python LIB set packages from GTTS. So I have already installed it, that's why this message is coming on the screen. But if you did not install it, then it will first download your module directly from the Python server, and then it will install it on the one go. So let's start. So let us first of all close this. I'm gonna minimize it. So this is our IDLE, right? So let's open a new script page, and now we will write some code. So I have already told you that we use it mainly for speech recognition only, because it is fast and accurate. So let's import speech recognition. Import speech _ recognition. Okay, so we have imported our speech recognition program. Now what we have to do is, we will import GTTS. Okay, so we have imported GTTS also. Now I'm gonna define a function, def listen, which will have no parameters, since we are speaking, our voice will be a parameter. So what we will do is, now we have to write here as let me write here something more as SR, so that we don't have to write speech recognition full length again and again and again. Okay, so what we have to do is we will write, we will define, assign a variable, let's say R is equals to SR dot recognizer with capital R, recognizer R equal to SR dot recognizer. Okay, now this is first variable. Now we are going to do, we are going to write some more code with SR dot microphone, okay, with capital M. Okay, microphone with SR dot microphone, then two parentheses as as source, since I'm using microphone for my audio source, I will write it here as, I will write it as okay, source. Now what we have to do is we will define another variable, that is A is equals to R dot listen. Okay, and now we will write source so that it will listen the source. Now what do we have to do is try and accept. We will go to the typical try and accept format. So try, then colon. So what we will try to do is let's say we have to, I think we have to define a new variable. Actually we have already defined variable here. Okay, so now what we are going to write here is return. We need some return value, obviously, guys. Return, what do we need in return is R dot recognize, recognize, then underscore Google. Okay, R dot recognize underscore Google and then A, because A is the variable which is containing, which is storing our audio file. So we will try to do this, and if it does not happen, what can happen is except unknown. Sorry guys, we don't have to write capital K, it is small K. Okay, unknown, then capital V, then value, then E capital for error, unknown value error. Okay, except unknown value error, then colon, then we will write print could not understand audio. Let's say could not understand audio. And audio. Okay, so another thing which can happen is request error. So to solve that also, we are going to write it here except, and then so what we have to do is sr dot request error method of request error, and then what we have to do is print record error and then dot format, remember guys, it is a really big it is actually a big word. So what we will do is we will do some changes, obviously, as e, let's say. Okay, so we will write here format and in the parenthesis e. So we have defined our lesson function. So let me tell you guys, where did we use the GTDF? Actually, I have already told you that GTDF is the module that we mainly use for speech recognition, right? So here we used to write strings so that the pocket strings will get the values and the pocket strings will return the text, the printed string text, okay? But here we have written the Google. That means it will use the GTDF module to connect to the Google server on the online, and that will give you the results back on the screen in the printed form. So let's try this and see whether it works much more greatly than much more great than pocket strings or not. So first of all, save it. Let's say GTT, that's it, and we have saved it. Now we will call the listen function to test it. Now we have again saved it. Now I'm gonna run it. Remember guys that I have connected with internet constantly because GTTS needs constant internet to work. The IDL is bad this time. Let's run it. Let's try it again. Okay, now I'm gonna just say something. Okay, hello man, what are you doing? Okay, you can. Oh man, I'm such a noob actually. Well, you can see here that I didn't write fr dot because unknown value error doesn't mean anything in itself. It is from the speech recognition module. That means I have to write fr. Now we will save it again. Let's run it again. What are you doing? Okay, recognizer attribute has no. Recognize the object has no attribute, recognize dot underscore Google. So I think there is a spelling mistake, I think, right? Let me see. Okay, so we don't need a capital R, a small r is working. So let's run it. Oh man, how much mistakes I used to do. Please work this time correctly. What? Okay, it did not give us anything. That's a bad thing. Bad, bad, bad. So what is the problem? We should see. So we have used our try except function. Okay, we are getting audio file from A. We are recognizing it with the help of Google. We have took care of every error. Now what is the problem? Why is it not giving us any string or word? Okay guys, I got it. I didn't write this code. Return then string, it will return us a string of what we will speak. Okay, so now let's save it and run it again. Remember guys that we are using GTDF just for online help support. Okay, and this time also it did not give us any I don't know what's happening, but I will find out in this video only. Well, I'm gonna run it again. Hello. It is not giving us any output. Why? Let me see. Okay, so we have completed our function almost. So what are we missing? Okay, the variable is there, everything is there. We want to print our words, right? That means we have to do something else. Oh, guys, I am a noob in this thing. Sorry, guys. Actually, we have to define a new variable that will print everything. So let's say k is equals to sorry, not here. It will be here, okay? Because we are trying here this place. So let's write r is equals to r dot recognize. Actually, I will cut this. Okay, I will keep it as a variable. And now what I'm gonna do is I will write here print r. So that means I'm such a noob that I was thinking that return and then string will produce a string in front of me. But the problem is that the function is correct. It is producing the string, but it is not printing on the screen because we didn't told the function to print whatever it listens. This is what we have done now. Now let me explain you guys the whole code again. First of all, it will initialize the SR.WaveRecognizer, then it will use the microphone as source. Now it will get that audio in a audio file, and I don't know the format. So I don't know about which kind of format it stores, maybe a wave format. Now with a try and accept method, here we have defined a variable r is equal to r.recognize underscore google so that it can recognize what we are saying with the help of Google from the online server. And then we have written print r, that means it have to print whatever we have saved. So now it should work. I'm gonna save it again and let's run it. Well, this time it should work. I don't know whether it will work or not, but it should work now. And let's see what happens. Okay, you can see, guys, that it is not 100%, but at least it is much better than Sphinx, because Sphinx was horrible. That does not listen. If it listens, then it produces wrong sentences. We have to say one word again, 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 again for it to recognize that one word. So, but the Google is a lot more accurate. Okay, let's run it again and see what happens. Hello guys, this is Raj Shivare, and please don't forget to subscribe my channel. And I want your suggestions, comments, and whatever you can write in the comment box. Okay, you can see that whatever I have told it, written it here. Hello guys, how's your day? And please don't forget to subscribe my channel. And I want your suggestions, comments, and whatever you can write in the sandbox. Okay, comment box. It wrote sandbox instead of comment box, but you can see that it is a lot more accurate than the strings. But the thing is that it offers only 50 calls a day. That means you can only get 50 results in a day, and but the Sphinx was offline and you can have it. And the Sphinx is the Pocket Sphinx is also an open source. And I don't know what to say now, because both of them have some drawbacks and both of them have some good things also, good qualities also. So I think they are equal in some aspects. So I won't say anything much more about them. So if you have any questions, if you want to suggest anything to me about the content, about the GTDS, about how I can make my content and video much more good than this, and if you want to ask me any question about the GTDS and the core and the functionality of GTDS, then please you can give your suggestion and question in the comment box. I will definitely read them and I will definitely reply them also, guys, because gaining the subscribers trust is really hard, and I will do everything whatever it takes to gain your trust. So the thing is that if you have any questions, then please comment them in the comment box, and please don't forget to subscribe my channel, because this channel is not just for teaching, because it is for getting knowledge also, guys. I also always get knowledge from you guys, from your comments, from your suggestions, from your questions also. And that's it for this video. And if you like my video, then please give it a thumbs up. If you don't like my video, then give it a thumbs down. But I hope that you like my video, and we will meet in the next video. So till then, goodbye.